Alright folks, today I'm gonna show you how to create this great looking planked Greek puff pastry roll. So stay tuned. Time to grill. So this one is a great side dish or could be a main dish for summer days, for hotter days, combined with salads and nice drinks. We're gonna get started with cutting the veggies. This is red bell pepper. We're gonna need some spring onions. I will speed this up a little bit. We're gonna need some garlic as well. I like my garlic chopped finely. There are a lot of people who are using this garlic press. I don't like that. For me, it's not an opportunity. So after chopping up the garlic, we're gonna need some pepperoni. These are pickled pepperonis. I love them, especially the hotter ones, but you can use any pepperoni you like. You can use fresh if you prefer the fresh one. So we have put our cast iron pan onto the grill. It's cold. We had some olive oil in there. You might have seen that. And we're gonna put these in there and heat it up with a pan. This has an effect, so the onion is a little bit sweeter. We're gonna heat this up a little bit, stir every here and then. And after several minutes, so 5 or 10 minutes or so, make sure not to burn the garlic. We're gonna add the bell pepper and the pepperoni, and we're gonna cook this for approximately another 5 till 10 minutes until the bell pepper is completely softened. And of course you can add more ingredients. You can use olives, you can add the things you need. This is the stuffing for our puff pastry roll. Smells pretty good right now. We're gonna close the lid and then we're gonna prepare the puff pastry. So this is a convenience piece of puff pastry. I hope you can buy this in any supermarket in the US the same way and easy as we can do it here in Germany. Then take a knife and cut it that way, approximately 1/3 from the side. So that's important. 1/3 each side on the outer side is for cutting, and the other third in the middle is for putting the stuffing or replacing the stuffing. So, have you checked out my Porsche knives? I will put the link in the video description. There will be a link for the US guys if you want to check out these awesome looking knives. So once you have cut them like so, we were now able to add the stuffing. So there you go. Just the whole length. Pretty easy. And only two more steps missing right now. We're gonna add some feta cheese here. Of course you can use any other cheese if you don't like feta cheese. For me this one is perfect for Greek style. But if you're more into Gouda, cheddar, Swiss cheese, Gruyere, whatever, use the cheese you like. So of course I will put an exact amount of ingredients into the video description as always. This is the seasoning, this is Terrano Meersalz, my own seasoning, which is perfect here, fits perfect as well, because this one includes dried oregano, dried tomato, and dried olives, and this is just the Mediterranean flavor we need. So, and then just fold the outside strings we've cut to the middle, and if you're a little bit into doing things like this, it should look quite good. So, and if you have cut these the way we did it here, it's easy to close it on both sides because there's enough puff pastry over left over. So, this is a cedar plank. This is not watered, so, has not soaked up water. We don't need that because this one will only grill on indirect heat. So, we only take the cedar plank. I'll put a link into a cedar plank if you haven't checked out cedar planks as well into the video description. Now take the puff pastry and place it on the cedar plank. I just do the this little trick with the baking sheet here hasn't done 100%, there's one little tiny, so then it's inside again. So place it there, and only one step to go before grilling. This has almost the perfect size for the puff pastry. We're gonna brush this one with extra virgin olive oil. So this is also Greek style olive oil from one of my friends, Eftimios Christakis. Thanks and greetings here in the English spoken version as well. So we're gonna brush this one. Of course you can use egg yolk if you're not too much into brushing puff pastry with olive oil, but I bet most of you haven't tried this out yet. So give this a shot, give this a shot. And we're gonna put this on the grill right now. We're gonna put this on our Broil King gas grill for approximately 35 minutes. Also, the left and the right burners are completely on full power. The grill has a temperature of 200 degrees Celsius, approximately 390 to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. And keep on looking, and if it's golden brown, like so, we are able to take this off, let it cool down a bit, and then we cut and see how we did. So that's it. Make sure on your grill that if it's if the heat is not, if your grill has not an equal heat, you just give it a turn a little bit or so. So we're gonna cut in there and see how we did. Please hit that like button, thumbs up, and comment. If you haven't subscribed to 0815 Barbecue, you can do it now by clicking on the logo on the left side of your screen. I'm gonna give this a shot. Thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.